Only you can answer the question today, but one of the three will fit you. One of the three relationships that we're talking about today, of four, will fit you. So where art thou with God? Second thing I want you to see this morning is where art thou in your position in the family of God? Where is your position in the family of God? Have you found a place of service? Do you have a church home? And friend, if you don't, let me encourage you to come. Amen. We would love to have you to be a part of the family of God here at New Beginning Tabernacle. Well, friends not only become friends, but friends become family. And we would love to have you here with us in the service of God. The Bible tells us as believers in Christ, we should use every gift that we have available to us. We all in here this morning have a gift. Have a gift. Some of us have more than one gift. Some of us got the gift of the gab. Some of us, hey man, we can talk faster than a single sewing machine can sew. And I'm just kidding there, amen. Just lighten up a little bit. Amen. But we got a gift. But why not use the gift for God? Why not give God the glory for the gift that He has given to you? The Bible says everything that we have is a gift from God. All the good things are gifts from God. 1 Timothy 6:17. Our food and our clothing is a gift from God. Why not give God the glory for that gift? And I'm glad, amen, all of you got clothes on this morning. Thank God. Amen. You got a gift from God this morning. Tell somebody, I thank God for the money that I had, amen, from God to buy these clothes. God gave me the strength to work for that dollar that I bought it with. God gave me the strength to work. If God didn't give you the strength to get up out of the bed tomorrow morning and go to that job, you wouldn't have the clothes upon your back. Thank God for the food that He placed on our table. Thank God. Amen. Matthew 6, 25 through 33, Jesus provided all of that for us, friend. It's a gift from Him. He told His disciples, don't you worry about what you're going to eat and what you're going to put on. I'll take care of you. Thank God He's taking care of us and give us these wonderful gifts. Rain and fruitful harvest in Leviticus 26. Faith. Without it, it's impossible to please Him. And thank God for the faith that you have in His Word and in Him. Grace. Wisdom. I thank God for wisdom, don't you? To know to do the right or the wrong thing. Amen. It's wisdom from God. And life itself is a gift from God. Life itself is a gift from God. None of us would be here today if God didn't breathe in our nostrils the breath of life. Let me tell you, friend, you can have the best doctors in the world. You can have the best that money can buy, but I guarantee you when the time for you to depart from this life, none of them will be able to save your life. But God who created you holds the breath of life within His hand. So where are you in the family of God? Are you using those gifts that God has given you? Are you involved? If not, I encourage you to get involved. Find a place. Amen. You can find it here if you're searching for it. And if you're looking for it, you can find it, amen, to serve God right here. But if you ain't looking for it, you ain't going to find it. It's like a lot of people looking for jobs, but they don't go nowhere, amen, to look for it. You can never find a job. It's not coming to you, right? You got to go to it. How many times, Jamie, you stayed at home and your job come right to you? Ain't got to do nothing. No, it doesn't happen that way. We have to put effort in it. And if we put the effort, God will open the door. And when God opens a door, no man can shut it. No man can shut it. So where art there in the family of God? And where are you in your relationship with God? And the final thing this morning, where art thou in your spiritual leadership within your home? Where are you in your spiritual leadership within your home? Let me share this with you this morning, and I believe this according to the authority of God's word, that men should be men. And men should be the spiritual leader of their household. I said men should be the spiritual leader of their household. The Bible clearly states, amen, as a man and woman join themselves together, they become one in flesh. And the man's responsibility is to love their wives even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it. And if we get that right, guys, then they don't mind giving, amen, the leadership role to you. But it's a shame that the woman has to take the leadership role from the man when the man is too lazy to assume it. When we find our relationship with God in the right fashion and the manner, we'll find our relationship at home goes very well with it, because we then, as men, will take our responsibility as Christ took his responsibility for the church. He will find himself praying, even as Christ prayed for his church. He will be the spiritual leader and also the prayer leader within his household. Ephesians 6:10, Ephesians 6:18, Ephesians 5:25 and 27. If you're looking for the scriptures to support it, it's here, baby. It's here. Come and listen. Amen. Come and listen. He keeps the family finances in order in 1 Timothy in chapter 3 and verse 12. If he doesn't know how to rule his own household well, he can never rule in the house of God. Yeehaw. Come on. Man, what do you mean? My wife takes care of all of that. Then you better get up, amen, and start taking care of business. What have you done? You allowed your wife to assume your responsibilities. And you, I know some of you ladies say, if I give it to him, he'll spend it all. He'll not. He needs to be responsible. Hello? He needs to be responsible. If he ain't spiritual with God, don't give him the finances, because he cheat on God, he'll cheat on you. Woo. Y'all going to throw rocks at me before I finish this one up, huh? If he cannot rule his own household well, how can he rule the house of God? I'll move on. I won't say any more, but I was going to fix it and say something else. Not only does he find himself, amen, as the prayer leader and the spiritual leader, but he's the mentor of his children. He mentors their life, his children, in Ephesians 6:4. Our children should never look to someone in the world to be their role model. It should be in the home with mom and dad. And not only in the home, but his friends and family should see that he is a role model. And they should desire what he has or she has. So where are there in your spiritual leadership? And ladies, I'm not leaving you out of this either. Because see, when Adam married Eve and God performed that first marriage, they became one. So as much responsibility lies on him, it lies on you. And you work hand in hand. Thought I'd just clear that up. Now, Let's clear another thing out of the air. You still with me? When I talked about finances, as long as he knows what's going on financially wise, ladies, you can write the check. As long as you in concert with one another, you know what each other is doing. You work together hand in hand. You both are spiritual leaders of your household. You both are mentors to your children. You both are role models to your friends and your neighbors. So how is that relationship looking? Where art thou is the question that God poses to you and I today. Where are we in our relationship with Him most of all? Are we walking with God? Are we walking with God? Are we doing the right things? Let me share this with you too, friend, while I'm here, because see, this has been a bad situation in the world too. Friend, today, if you living together, it's wrong. If the man don't want to marry you, ladies, get rid of that buzzer. He's no good to you. Amen. And I'm going to just tell it like it is. Amen. Jesus told the Samaritan woman, He says, go get your husband. She said, Lord, I don't have no husband. He said, you well said you had five husbands. One you're living with, it ain't yours. Hang on. He said that, you know, basically when he got through with her, she knew that wasn't right. That's why she went back and said, you come and see a man who told me everything I ever done is not this or Christ. And if we're going to do it, we're going to do it right. We're going to do it His way. Get married, amen. Take my responsibility. Put my pants on, if you will. And take my responsibility as a man. Amen. If he's going to lie with you, then he needs to marry you. Amen. And don't, women, don't ever lower yourself down to that standard. Amen? You got a higher standard than that. And make the men live up to it. Amen? God gave you something precious. And don't ever lose it. And I'm going to be like Forrest Gump. That's all I got to say about that. But until we get our relationship right with God, we'll never get it right. As spiritual leaders of our home, sharing our gifts with one another, or being the role model that we need to be. So where are you this morning? I'll leave that question with you. Only you know that, and God knows that. But let me tell you, you won't fool God. He knows exactly where you are. He knew exactly where Adam and Eve hid themselves. But He wanted to be the lighthouse to warn them. Amen. You can go that way if you want to. But I guarantee you, if you go that way, you'll meet consequences for that decision. And let me tell you, their friend, they choose to come back and mend that relationship because God killed an animal and clothed them, amen, with His righteousness. And that's what He's got to do for you and I. We got to be clothed in His righteousness, not our own righteousness, not our own way of thinking, but His way. His way to find that grace and mercy. So where art thou in our relationship with God? And where are you in the spiritual family of God? And where are you as a spiritual leader of your household? Only God and you know. So I'm asking you to allow God to do a work in your life this morning that only He can do. Maybe you never had a relationship with God. He's calling you today too. He's calling out to you to come and have that personal relationship with Him. He's willing to forgive you of your sin if you'll only ask. He's willing to...